Okay, welcome back guys. In this video, I'm going to get our image back that we have stored into our Firebase storage. For that purpose, let me go back into our activity underscore main. First of all, I'm going to create a button over here so that we can move to our second activity. And I would be calling this button move button. And I would say here move to second activity. Okay, and this would be below of our upload btn. Okay, that's it. Next step, in the main activity, at the end of this, I'm going to create a method public void move to show image activity, and to make it clickable, I'm going to pass the view over here. Let me surround this with try catch block. Going to copy this from here, paste over here, and here I would be calling start activity new intent from this activity to show message activity dot class. Okay, and next thing, I'm going to call this method on the on click of this button. Okay, that's it. Now, as you all know that we have already created the layout for this activity, first of all, I'm going to get the link of our image that we have stored into our cloud Firestore. I'm going to get these links that we have stored into our Firebase Firestore. Okay, for that purpose, let me get the header text first, in which we will put the name of our image that we want to retrieve, name of image, header text, and then we need an image view as well. Image view, this would be downloaded image view, and then we will be needing an object of Firebase Firestore, and this would be equal to object Firebase Firestore. So here I'm going to create a try catch block. Okay, and first of all, let me check the IDs for download image name 80 and download image. I would be saying name of image et would be equal to find view by id r dot id download image name et, and next thing, download image view would equal to find view by id r dot id download image, and then we are going to initialize our object of Firebase Firestore that would be equal to Firebase Firestore dot get instance. Next thing, as we are going to get the document back into our application, we will be needing document reference. So we have created the object of this document reference. Now I'm going to create a method over here. First, I'm going to create some room, and this method will be used to download the image. I would be saying download image. I'm going to pass the object of view. And let me surround it with try catch block. Okay, so first thing we need to do is to check that user should not enter empty value inside our header text, which is this one. For that purpose, let me have this if name of image header text dot get text dot toString dot is empty, this should not be empty, else if user puts the empty value, then we will create a toast in which we will be saying please enter an image name. Okay, so after that, we are going to initialize our document reference would equal to object Firebase Firestore dot collection, and the name of collection is links, and after that we are going to give the name of our document, which is stored in the name of image et dot get dot toString. Okay, next thing I'm going to do is to object document reference dot get dot add on success listener, new on success listener, and after that I'm going to add on failure listener, new on failure listener. If we fail to get the image back, then we will say fails to get image, just close it, and if we successfully get the image back, then image link will be stored inside this document reference. Okay, so I'm going to create a variable over here, and this would be link of image, and I'm going to get this document snapshot.get, and here I would be passing the name of the field in which we have stored our images. So if you check that the name of the fields in which we have stored our URL is URL. Okay, so I would be passing here URL. Okay, and here I would be calling the method string, get string. Okay, just change it to string. Now the next step we are going to do is to call the library called glide. Okay, in order to use the library glide, you have to add the dependency, go into your app folder, and at the end of this, just add this com.github.bumptech.glide colon glide dot 4.9.0, and then just click on sync now. After you add the glide dependency, it is very easy to get our image from a downloadable link. Now go back into show image activity, and here inside your onSuccess method, call glide dot with, here pass the context which is show message activity dot this, and then with load, and here you just have to provide the link of the image that you want to load, and after that into, and you are going to download in that into your image view with the name of download image view. Okay, then just close this. This is the image view that we have created over here inside our activity underscore show dot image dot xml. Okay, and after that just call this method on the on click of this download image button. I will be calling on click download image. That's it. Okay, so we are all done for our image that we are going to download. Just run the application. So as you can see that our emulator is ready, just click on move to second activity. Okay, so in this text view, I just have to pass the name of document ID that I want to retrieve. If you don't know about the document ID, then these are the document IDs by which we will get our downloadable link. Okay, so first of all, I'm going to say and click download image. Okay, there you go. Our image has been downloaded into our image view. If I click on Y and click on download, then the Y image will be downloaded into our application. So that's it for this part of the tutorial series, in which I have told you guys that how to upload image into your Firestore, then how to save the downloadable link into your Firestore, Firebase Firestore, and then how to get that image back into your application by using the Glide library. Okay, in the next videos, I'm telling you guys that how to get your image back into your recycler view. So see you guys in the next videos.